my dear kids, very good afternoon and welcome to today's session. Today we gonna see our semester 2 lesson 1, okay, decimals. I hope you guys watch our last class video. Keep watching our video and whatever doubt you have, just call or text me, okay. So in this lesson we gonna discuss how to write a fraction as decimal, and as well as how to write decimal as a fraction, how to expand the fraction, expand a decimal number, as well as how to compare a decimal number. Okay, shall we start? Before that, please take your textbook, your pencil, your workout note, and the class works, okay, along with you. Okay, whenever I am reading important points, you should underline that. Keep your pencil with you. Whenever I am reading, please you should also read along with me, okay? Okay guys, first move this takeoff section. In this takeoff section, so here one question is there. I brought two chocolates for rupees 1. What is the cost of each chocolate? Okay, so total amount is rupees 1. I brought two chocolates, so 1 divided by 2. Should do the division. So here 1 is there, isn't it? So keep a decimal point and keep the 0 here. Okay, keep the 0, so it becomes 10. Then do the division. Okay, that is 2 divide. So 5 into 2 gives you 10. So 2 is here, so 5. Okay, 5 to 7. Okay, so you get the answer as 0.5. So in this takeoff session, you should understand what is the use of decimal and what's the use of decimal point. Okay, the very first number is the old number. So here 0 is here. After the old number, there should be a decimal point after a decimal part is there. Okay, come to this next section. Afterwards, in this decimal section, you will get a clear idea about this decimal. Okay, so in this second question also the same thing. My brother brought 4 bananas for rupees 10. What's the cost of each banana? So same thing, 10 divided by 4, you will get the answer as 2.5. in this 2.5, 2 is the old number. Okay, 2 is the old number. To separate this old number and this decimal part, in between we use a point. This point is called the decimal point. Okay, the dot that separates the old number from the decimal part is called the decimal point. Guys, please underline this. The dot that separates the old number from the decimal part is called as the decimal point. Okay, now come to the section tens. Okay, tens. So what does tens means? See here an example. 2.56. okay, so after this, the first, this is the old number part, this is decimal point, this is the decimal part. Okay, the first number is called as tens, after hundreds, like that. Here also, here what will come up? Ones, tens, hundred, thousand, we know this. So after the decimal point, the very first number is called as tens. Okay, here we have one rectangular bar. Okay, next, divide this rectangular part into 10 equal parts. Out of this 10 parts, here I shaded the very first. So out of this 10, I shaded the very first part. One of the part I shaded. So what is the fraction of this? 1 by 10. So 1 by 10 is written as 0.1. Before that, an important thing is there. In tens, there is one decimal place. Okay, in tens, there is one decimal place. Guys, please underline this, very very important. Okay, now how to read this? 1 by 10 is equal to 0.1. this read as 0.1, as well as see, come to the next one. Here 10 parts are there. Out of this 10, 6 part is colored. Okay, so how to write this fraction? Out of 10, 6 part is colored. So 6 by 10. How to write this decimal for this? 0.6. In tens, there is only one decimal places. After the decimal point, there should be only one decimal places. Okay, so 6 by 10 is equal to 0.6. are you clear, guys? So it is read as 0.6. 0.1 and 0.6 are the decimal numbers. So how to come to this, fill in the blanks. 0.7 is read as 0.7. Okay, 1.5 is read as 1.5. Okay, again same thing. shaded region is here. 10, out of this 10, four parts are shaded. So 4/10 is equal to how to write? So here and the denominator there should be only one zero. So you should understand like this. If the decimal point after the decimal point, the decimal part, it depends upon the number of zeros in the denominator. Okay, if it is 10, so there should be after the decimal point there should be only one number. Okay, this zero decided the number of decimal numbers after the decimal point. Okay, here 10, so because of that after the decimal point there should be only one number. Guys, please understand this like this. Okay, it's very easy. If you study like this, it's easy for you to identify. Okay, so 4/10 is equal to 0.4, as well as 8/10 is equal to, what's the answer, ma? 0.8. okay, are you clear? Now come to this next example. Shaded region, one full rectangular bar is there. Next bar is divided into 10 equal parts. Out of this 10 equal parts, 7 part is cut. So 7/10. So how to write the fraction? So 7/10 is equal to, how to write the decimal, ma? 7/10 is a fraction. So how to write this fraction to decimal? 0.7. Next, add this to 1 plus 0.7. That gives you 1.7. Guys, are you clear? Next section. Here, two full rectangular bars are there. So, 1 plus 1, 2 plus. Here, out of this 10, 3 parts are colored. So, 3/10. We know that 2 plus 0.3 gives you 2.3. Is the answer. Are you clear, guys? Now, come to this example, okay? Just find the place value of the digit 234.5. So before that, for easy understanding, here I expand the number first. Okay, how to expand this 234? First, we can see this whole number part: 200 plus 30 plus 4 plus after the point. How to write this decimal part? 5 is there, means write as 5/10. Okay, write as 5/10. Okay. Now, place this number in this place value chart. Okay, this you know very well. I am right. 1, 10, 100, 1000. This is go like that in the left side. In the on the right, after the decimal point, tens. Afterwards, hundreds. Afterwards, thousands. It will be there. Okay. Now, place this number in this place value chart. We have 200. So, below the 100, right here 2. Below the 10, right here 3. Because 3 tens. Okay, 3 tens. Below the 1, right 4. 4 ones. Okay, afterwards point is there, 5 is there, so tens. So 1/10 is below the 1/10, write as 5. Okay, are you clear? Now we're gonna write the place value. Okay, 2, place value of 2 is 2 into 100 gives you 200. Here 3 into 10 gives you 330. 1 into 4 gives you 4. 5 into 1/10 gives you 5/10. We know 5/10 is equal to 0.5. This is the way of finding the place value. Are you clear, guys? Next, we're gonna see the hundreds. Okay, hundreds. H-U-N-D-R-E-D-T-H-S. It is 1/100. Okay, tens means 1/10. Hundreds means 1/100. Divide the whole into this whole. Into this is a whole means full. Full part into 10 equal parts. 10 equal parts. Each part is 100. Each part, this particular part, we can call as 1/100. 1/100. Are you clear, guys? Underline this. In hundreds, there are 2 decimal places. Please underline that. In tens, we studied that. In tens, there are only 1 decimal places. In hundreds, there are 2 decimal places. Okay, come to this example. Here in this blocks, out of this 100 blocks, 7 blocks are shaded. 7 blocks are shaded. So how to write this? The decimal of this fraction is 7/100. So out of 100, 7 of the portion are shaded. So 7/100, that's equal to 0.07. We already seen here, in hundreds there are 2 decimal points. That is, after the decimal point, there should be 2 decimal places. There should be. Already we seen the zero decided how many number should be there after the decimal point. Here 7 by 100 that's equal to after the point there should be two numbers. So 0.07 is the answer. So after the decimal there should be two numbers. Are you clear, guys? So come to this example. In this example, so there are 100 parts are there. Out of this 100, 45 are colored. 45 are shaded. Okay. So now how to write the fraction? We know that here there are two zeros. So there should be two numbers should be there after the decimal point. So here two numbers are there. Write the number as it is. If it is one number is there, means as we seen here, keep only one zero and one the particular number. Here we have two number. So guys, write the two number as it is and keep a zero. So the answer is 0.45. Okay, it's read as 0.45. Okay, likewise we have one more example. Here two shaded portion. Okay, two fully shaded. So it's called as what, ma'am? Two. So two fully shaded. So here is one. Here is also one. One, two. So two fully shaded. And out of this, 37 of the portion are shaded. So 100 divided by 37. Okay, guys, are you clear? So what's the answer? So 2 plus 0.37. So the answer is 2.37 is the answer. Okay, let's move on to this example. Like what we seen before for the tens. Here the thing is same thing. Here the only difference is here after the tens we have hundreds. Okay, so here's a question. 5012.78. So how to split this 5000 plus 0 100? So we know this is, I'm right, ones, tens, hundred, and thousand. So 5000. 0 100, 1 10s, and 2 1s. Okay, and after this point is there for 1 by 10s. First number is 7. For 1 by 100s is 8. Okay. Okay. The place value of 1 is already we seen here. So place value is 5 is what? 5 into 1000 gives you 5000. Place value of 0 is 0 into 100 is 0. Again, place value of 10 is 1 into 10, 10. Place value of 1 is 2 into 1, 2. Again, place value of 10 is 7 into 1 by 10. That's equal to 7 by 10. See here, 7 by 10. So 7 by 10 is equal to 0.7. Here also the same thing. Next page, 100 is 1 by 100 into 8. So that's equal to 8 by 100. So 8 by 100 is equal to 0.08. Are you clear, guys? Okay, guys, come to this fill in the blanks. It's very simple. So 0.05 is read as 0.05. So just like how you read, write just like that. Okay, 0.325. Here dash is read as 0.9. Okay, guys, please copy this. Now we move on to the next session, thousands. Okay. Here, see this place value chart, you'll get the idea. So here we discussed 10, already we discussed 10s, 100s. So the new term is, the next new and the next term is thousands. Okay. So 1 by 1000 is equal to 0.001. This read as 0.001. Okay. So 54 divided by 1000 gives you 0.054. The thing is, in thousands, there are 3 decimal places. Very, very important. In tens there are only 1 decimal places. In hundreds there are 2 decimal places. In thousands there are 3 decimal places. Okay. Now move on this place value chart. Here 641.278. Just keep this places number in this place value chart. Okay, now 600, the place value of 6 into 100, 600. Place value of 4 is 4 into 10, 40. 1 into 1. Okay, next, after the point, 10s. So 2 into 1 by 10 gives you 2 by 10 is equal to 0.2. Again, 7 into 1 by 100, 8 into 1 by 1000. Likewise. Okay, so here, after the decimal point, there should be 3 number. Don't forget this. okay? After the decimal point, there should be three number. Write this number at first, okay? Then next write the remaining. Should write the zeros. Okay, guys, are you clear? Okay, guys, let's see some of the examples. Okay, x plus each decimal as a fraction. So 0.5 means after the decimal is 1 point. So just reverse 5 divided by 10. Here after the decimal 2 points are there. So 56 divided by 100. Okay, here after the decimal point there is 3 numbers are there. So 9 divided by 1000. Here 5.6 is equal to 56. See, after the decimal point 1 number is there. So in the denominator there should be 10. So 56 divided by 10. Here after the decimal there are 2 points. So denominator it contains 2 zeros. And what's the answer, ma? Write this number 478. Here after the decimal there should be 3 numbers. So denominator comes it as 1000. 3 zeros. Okay. Now write this number as it is. Remove this decimal point. Okay. And write this number as 3765. Okay. Next example. X plus each fraction as decimal. Okay. Just reverse of this. Here in above section we seen decimal as a fraction. Here we gonna see fraction as a decimal. Okay. 7 by 10 is equal to already we seen 0.7. 6 by 1000 means after the decimal there should be 2 numbers. So 0.6. 0.06. Here after the decimal there should be a 2 numbers. So keep a point. After the decimal there should be 2 numbers. So from your right to left keep 2 point. Okay. So 5.67 is the answer. Okay. 5.67. Here 47 divided by 10. So after the decimal point there should be 1 number. So in between write 4.7. Here 2 number should be there. So write this 2 number to the after the decimal point. So 0.87. Here 3 numbers are there, but the denominator contains 2 number. Keep the decimal point, use 0 and write this 3, 4. So 0.34 is the answer. Okay, guys, are you clear? Now, guys, let's move to the next example. Which is greater? Here we have 2 sets of decimal numbers. In these decimal numbers, we want to find which is the greater number. For to find easier, so we use this place value chart. Okay, like write the very first number. Before that, we have this place value chart. We have 100. 100 means 100, 10, 1. This is a place for point. Okay, again, 10th means 1 by 10. Here, 100th means 1 by 100. So just arrange those first, the very first number in this place value chart. We have 200. So write 2, 3 tens, write 3, 4 ones, 4, point is there. Here we have, soon after point, we have 5. So write the 5 here and write the 6 here. Okay. Now come to the next number. So we have again, we have 200, 3 tens, 4 ones, point is there. 6, 5 is there. So, 6 and 5. Okay. Now, compare the numbers. In this, hundreds, tens, ones, both are same. Here also 2, here 2, here 3, here 3, here 4, here 4. So, here it is same. So, all number parts are same. Now, move on to this after the decimal point. Okay. First, here in this tens section, we have 5, here we have 6. So which is bigger? Both are different numbers. Now we want to compare these two numbers and find which is bigger, which is greater. Okay. 5 is bigger or 6 is bigger, my dear kids? Yes. 6 is bigger. So 5 is less than 6. Am I right? So just compare this tens. We can easily find out which is, we got the answer, which is bigger. Am I right? So which is the bigger number, ma? The second one is the bigger. Second one means 234.65 is greater. Okay, guys, are you clear? Thus, you should write the answer. Thus, 234.65 is the greater number. Okay, this is the answer. This is very easy to compare two decimal numbers. The very easiest method. Okay. So let's move to the next example. Arranging in ascending order. So as we now we seen how we know how to find the greatest number. Am I right? So likewise, uses same method to find the ascending order. Ascending order two means what? Ma, small to big. So for arranging this, first we want to compare all the whole number part. Here the whole numbers are same. Here every number, every sets of number contain 34. Am I right? 34. Okay. Now just move on to the next number. Soon after the decimal point, the very first number, 10th number is there that you want to compare. Okay. Here the first number contains 7. Here also 7. Next here 6 is here. So 7 is bigger or 6 is bigger? Yes, 7 is bigger than 6. So 6 is smaller. So compare this two number. In this two number, which is smaller, ma, here 34.62, here 34.68. Both contain 6, but after the 10th position here in this session, 100th position contains 2, here 8. So which is smaller, ma? This is small. So the first answer is 34.62. So we know the next answer is this, 34.68. Now these two numbers are same, am I right? Here soon after the decimal point we have 7 in both the session. So next, let's show the next number which is smaller. When 72 is here, see here 78 is here, which is smaller, ma? This 34.72 is smaller. 34.78 is next number. Okay, likewise you should arrange the numbers. So our ascending order means smaller to bigger number. Okay guys. Okay, this is the answer for ascending order. Okay, in this we have one section, one small homework is there. Complete the following number patterns. Please guys, please try to do this. Okay, so whatever doubt regarding this decimal, this chapter, so after watching this video, if you have any doubt, if you're feeling any doubt regarding this topic, don't forget to call or text me. You can ask me, I will clear it out. Okay guys. Okay, thank you.